All right, we're at PSA. What do we got?
Hi, guys. My name is Max Stalin with Palmetto State Armory. This is our STG-44 reproduction. It's chambered in the original 8mm Kurtz, 7.62x39, 5.56, and 300 blackout. A few small differences from the original. These are threaded, more common drip pitches, F28 and 5/8-24, so you can attach a suppressor. Other than that, this is the exact same as shooting an STG-44. It gives the same sight picture, weight, feel, everything.
Yeah,
we're excited to release these this year. We think everybody's going to be really happy with these.
What's the price point on that?
We haven't finalized on it, but it's going to be somewhere north of $2,000. But again, that's not official. We haven't finalized it. They're going to be released this year.
And how much of this do you guys make in-house?
Everything.
Everything?
Yes, sir.
Wow.
This is as is produced. This is stamp sheet metal, cut parts. This is not 22.
Man, that looks amazing. I've always wanted one, but there's no way I can afford, you know.
And if you had one, you don't really want to go shoot it because it costs you $100,000.
Absolutely. Awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
Thank you.
All right. Now we're with Thomas. What do we got?
Hey, guys. Tom from PSA. So we got a couple new guns that we want to show. We're going to walk through the Dagger lineup right now. So this is the Dagger Compact you guys know and love. That's that 15-round grip, 4-inch slide. We are showcasing a couple new things. You'll see a new compensator. We're working with Parker Mountain Machine there on that. And then obviously, you know, you can get your Dagger however you want. That's what's great about the Dagger. So you see a gray frame on this one, black slide. We'll roll through a couple of the options we have up here. So that's the Dagger Compact. And then we're also looking at a couple different new variants. So this is a concept gun, so think concept car. This is the Dagger full size L. So you guys are probably familiar. This is that 17 size. So you got 17 round grip, 4.5 inch slide. We're trying to take a pulse and see if that's something you guys want. So definitely let them know. Now we got a couple other new guns and a couple other coming soon. You guys can kind of see it right here, and I'll get you guys a little bit better angle there. So this is our Dagger Micro, and what's great about that is you got that full-size grip, but super slim and easy to conceal with 15 rounds of 9mm there. And if you want to zoom in a little bit on those magazines, those are really cool. So what's awesome about that, those will be compatible with your 43X 48s already without changing the mag catch. So you get that, you know, 50% more capacity with 15 rounds of 9mm. All in that slim, easy to conceal package. So
nice.
This is that Dagger Micro. That's coming soon. Not available just quite yet.
But coming soon is in like maybe a month or two, or
in a quarter or two or so.
Okay.
But you know, we try not to commit to dates and prices. Then we also have the Micro X. So what you'll see there, it's a slightly longer barrel, but still very, very easy to conceal. And what's great about that, it's a little bit easier to shoot. So if you're a little more recoil sensitive, definitely check out the Micro X. Now what I'm most excited about with the Dagger lineup is what's coming soon.
Oh man, that is amazing.
This is the Dagger Switch. And what's great about this, if you notice the black piece right there, that's a modular chassis that's compatible with all your Gen 3 accessories. So your trigger kits, your slide stops, so all dropped in there. What you see is a machined aluminum grip on there. And then you can mount any Dagger top end that we have today. So this right here is that 19 size, our Dagger Compact. But this same chassis right here could be configured into this right here, which is that 17 round grip. Obviously the interchangeable grip panels right there. These are machined aluminum. Probably come out with some G10 as well.
Nice.
But this has that 4.5 inch slide. So what's great is you can buy just this chassis soon and then configure it however you want. So think of it as like your AR-15 lower for your handgun. So we're going to come out with the aluminum grips first. Probably some polymer down the line.
But this, again, is not out until a quarter or two.
So these are concept guns. So definitely let us know if you like them.
But there's one right here.
Well, there's one
right here.
Exactly. So these are really exciting. We're getting a lot of good positive feedback. So definitely let us know if you want to see them.
Absolutely.
See them come to life.
Yeah, comment down below for sure. That thing looks wicked.
Well, and this is the PSA Dagger lineup.
Oh, check this out. Everyone loves the rocks. What do we got here?
All right. right, so what we got here is a bunch of lineups of rocks. So this is that 5.7 pistol you know and love. Best in class capacity with 23 plus one in the grip. And definitely one of the more ergonomic offerings. So what you see here is our rock. Now what we're coming out with, you'll notice we're coming out with a bunch of colors. So the rock used to be just black.
That color is, I don't know if it's coming out on camera, but that color is amazing.
Yeah, it's a nice kind of sniper green there. So we're going to be offering the frames here in green, black, flat dark earth, and gray. You kind of can see the whole lineup. What's also new, we're coming out with some new stylized slides. So similar to the Dagger, people want to be able to customize it. So you see, we've got the gold barrel, the bronze barrel, the chameleon color barrel, all with the different slide options here coming soon. And one of the new things that we, you know, we're talking about some concept guns. We've heard some from some of our customers, hey, I love the Rock, but can you have something a little bit smaller? So what we're showing here is a concept. So this one's not ready yet. We're just kind of taking a pulse, so definitely comment and let us know what you're thinking here. But what's nice about this is we chopped off about a half inch off the bottom. So as you can see, it's kind of that Goldilocks size grip right there that most people can fit their hands on. So half inch off the bottom, like about 3/8 off the front for a little bit more concealable package, but still probably getting 20 rounds. So
man, that's pretty very, very cool.
Yes, so definitely let us know what you think about those. But, you know, obviously click on the link and get yourself in one of these new Rock pistols.
Absolutely. I've been looking to pick one up pretty quick. All right. Now, what do we got here?
All right, guys. So we've got our Chinese Spiker model. This is a Type 56. It is a clone series. It's one of our clone series guns on Soviet arms. This one is as true to the original Type 56 as you're going to see. Took a lot of effort to make sure all the features are right. It's got your folding bayonet, you know, your correct Chinese markings, all of your aesthetic features that are true to the original Type 56. You know, down to the color hue of the wood, and just small subtle features that match the original Norinco's.
Nice. All right.
All right, guys. So down here we've got our ARC platform. This one is chambered in 6.5 Grendel. This will be coming out later this year. We'll have a 300 blackout offering as well. This is internally, it'll carry the same features as the original ARC and all of our AKs. Really, it'll be hammer forged bolt, carrier, and trunnion. Again, just chambered for your different calibers. We're going to expand, do some caliber expansions throughout the year. And this is one that's been highly anticipated. Everybody wants to have a, you know, kind of an accurate AK, and this is going to be the one that'll bring it.
Nice.
All right, guys, so this is our Krenkov AKS-74U. This, we've been working on this one for a little while. It's finally ready to release late quarter one, maybe early quarter two. Originally, we were going to release it in the, obviously, the original caliber 5.45 by 3.9. We will also release a 5.56, and those will be the first offerings, and then shortly thereafter, we're going to offer a 7.62 by 3.9 and a 300 blackout in this as well. Again, this is part of the Soviet arms line. This one will be a clone correct gun, aesthetically true to the original. Internally will be our gold hammer forged bolt carrier and trunnion, as all our other models offer.
What is this one?
All right, guys, so this is our AK. It's an AK-101, but as you see, this is chambered in 300 blackout. This is a new product for us. It'll be released very soon. It is built, again, on the 101 chassis, but it is chambered 300 blackout. It will have our new adjustable gas block for guys that want to run suppressed or unsuppressed. Everything else, again, true to our 101s, cold hammer forged internals. We'll have several different series of these rifles. Our 3 series will be the nitrided barrels. 4 series will be cold hammer forged chrome lined barrel that we make in-house. And then the 5 series will be cold hammer forged chrome lined from FN Manufacturing. Obviously, the nitride versions will be first, just like how we release all of our others. And then shortly thereafter, we'll have the cold hammer forged chrome lined in-house and then the cold hammer forged chrome lined FN.
So, Colton, I got to ask you, what is this thing?
So this is our blast director. It's not a true suppressor. It does not have the baffle like the original that it is meant to copy. The idea is, though, it gives you the aesthetics. We will have a version that is a barrel shroud for the rifles and then just a blast director for the pistols.
Great. So it's like a sound mitigating device?
That's right. That's right.
Yeah. All right.
Meant to look like the originals, but again, just give you the aesthetic look.
Very cool. But without the
functionality, so you don't class 3 them.
All right, let's do this monster.
All right, guys. So this is one of our 102s, obviously chambered 5.56. This one we brought out to kind of display some of the upcoming expansions on furniture build-outs that we will be offering. We're going to have longer hand guards, different colors, kind of expand on some of that for you guys to get a little more flavor in it if you want it from the factory and don't want to have to do that to yourself or do it yourself afterward. We'll have models with ALG triggers, side-folding braces, and again, long, short hand guards. Got a bunch of cool stuff coming on that, so stay tuned for that. Again, all same internals that we offer, Cold Hammer Forge chrome-lined internals, just like the rest of our Soviet Arms line.
Now, how much of this is made in-house?
Almost all of this rifle is made in-house now. We don't do much on the polymer injection mold. That's kind of a black magic to itself. We leave that to the injection mold guys. And the stampings, we don't do. Everything else we do in-house.
All right, now we're with Matt. He is the Jackal Guru at PSA, and he's going to go over some of these beautiful rifles. Which one are we looking at first?
Sir, so down here, you guys might already be familiar with the two Jackals that we have out right now, a 10.5-inch 5.56 and an 8.5-inch 300 Blackout. We decided to go ahead and expand on this Jackal line a little bit. We got a 13.7 here that is pin and welded with a J-Max comp with a chemo attachment to allow you to put some of your favorite suppressors on the rifle. It does bring the barrel out to a permanent 16-inch length, so you can put a folding stock on without having to do any of the NFA paperwork.
Right.
Up here above it, we have another 13.7 with our new Palmetto State Armory stock that we will be shipping on some of these rifles. It'll give you a good option for a different look on a Jackal. And above it, we have a 16-inch Jackal. This will get released around the same time as the 13.7. Again, it will have the long stroke piston, just like every other Jackal we sell.
Man, that's really nice. Out of these four, which one is your favorite?
This one right here is my personal favorite.
Yeah, it does look sharp. We have some other stuff coming out. This is out already or coming out?
So these are coming out also. This one that we're looking at right here is a 7.62x39 Jackal. We're going to run it on our standard KS-47 lower, so it'll take the Rock and Lock magazines. It will get released first in a 7.62x39. Same non-reciprocating side charger. Everything about it will be the same except for the magazines and the ammo it takes.
Right.
Down below it, we got our 9mm Jackals.
This gosh, look at this. This is so cool.
Sir, it'll be a another product offering in the Jackal line. We're going to start by running it on our ARV lower. So to serve the same controls as the ARV and the AKV and take the same Scorpion magazine, it will be served first and direct blowback.
Nice. What is this coming out? Do they have any kind of TBA? Maybe third quarter?
Maybe.
Maybe. All right. That's cool. And then this is similar.
Yes, sir. So that is another 9mm Jackal. This one is in 6.5-inch barrel. The one above is a 4-inch with a tuck flash cannon.
Very nice. Hey, Matt, thank you so much. I appreciate your time.
Sir.
And, man, these are really, really cool. I definitely want to get one of these for sure. Comment down below if you'd be interested in getting one of these. Do you have a price point on this? Guesstimate?
We have not formed a price point exactly on these rifles, but they should be pretty comparable to what we're selling right now.
All right, so this is definitely under $5,000. All right, everyone likes this retro style, and I'm here with Mike from PSA. Let's go over some of these rifles, man. This stuff looks really, really nice.
Yeah, so we've got here our M16A1 rifle. We'll be in shipping those probably by the end of March. It's classic A1. We're going to offer it in a 1-7 twist and a 1-12 twist. Fully chrome line, 4150 barrel, parkerized finish on that. Gray Type 3 hard coat anodizing. Basically as close as you can get in a modern build to an M16A1 from the Vietnam up through early 80s era.
Just no fun switch.
No fun switch.
Dang.
No fun switch. And then down below that, we've got the 723 carbine, which is a late 80s, early 90s transitional carbine. Bridge the gap between the Vietnam era guns and the adoption of the M4 carbine in the 90s. That one has a 1-7 twist only, 14.7 inch pinion welded barrel. This one is going to be a black Type 3 hard coat, 6th position car tube, and car stock. We've already been shipping some of these guns this week. First batch went out Monday. MSRP on that one is $1099. I don't have the pricing nailed down on the A1s yet. Most likely between $1,200 and $1,500 MSRP.
Yeah, but man, it would be so cool to have this just in the collection itself. I mean,
oh yeah,
so neat.
They're a great shooter, but also, you know, for reenactors and as a wall hanger in your man cave.
Oh yeah, a functional wall hanger.
Exactly.
A very functional wall hanger.
Down at the bottom, we've got our 635 pistol variant, and we're bringing back the Colt magazine style AR.
Yes.
To the H&R and the PSA family.
They take standard Colt mags?
Standard Colt style mags. I did a lot of work on the feed ramp over the last 6 to 8 months on this gun. It runs really, really well. We had the PSA variant at range day and not a single hiccup on it.
Outstanding.
Due to the brace ruling, I'm probably going to offer that gun as a rifle configuration with a 16-inch barrel, but we're also planning on offering complete lower halves and complete upper halves in the 10.5-inch barrel.
That's great. I have a ton of Colt mags. I love them. Some people don't like them. I love them.
And for all you guys that think metal form is the only game in town, the ASC mags will feed really, really well in our gun. I've done extensive testing, thousands and thousands of rounds. So, it'll use either ASCs or metal forms fine.
Outstanding. Mike, thank you so much for your time. Much appreciated.
You are very welcome.
All right, finally, last but not least, we are with Justin, and he's going to go over the Saber Defense.
Hey, guys. Justin with Palmetto State Armory. We got something we're super excited about. This is our new premium AR line, and all these are going to be under $1,000. The whole point of this project is to get a gun that the consumer can buy, and it's ready to go out of the box. They don't have to do any upgrades. So each of these rifles is going to come with a couple things. We got Springco upgrades in the extractor spring. We got Springco gas rings, and we got Springco buffer springs. And then they're all going to come upgraded with the Hyperfire trigger and the JP reduced power springs. So you have a 3.5 to 4 pound trigger pull out of the box. You're going to get upgraded pivot pins. You're going to get the Radian safety selectors, the Radian charging handle, and every one of them is going to come with a Microvest BCG. This is our new ready rail.
Okay.
In this instance, it's a AAC suppressor in there.
Oh yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Couldn't see it. I'm too short.
Yeah, so that'll fit pretty much most standard suppressors. I think it's the 1.5 circumference, I think, is what it fits. And then, so we're going to have the Forge series, which is going to be a little less price, and then the premium series will be the billet. So the billets have completely ambi controls, so you'll have an ambi bolt catch and a mag release. So, you got the left side as well.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah. And every one of them is going to have ambi safety selector. The Radians, you can do the 45 degree too if you'd like. So, but yeah, like I say, whole point of this project is to get a gun that the customer can buy out of the box, and all they have to do is throw an optic on it. They don't have to worry about doing anything else.
So I like it. What's this one down here?
So these are, we're trying to bring the quad rails back. So we got the quad rails. We got these that don't have, they're time barrel nuts, so it's a really clean look. There's no locking tab on the bottom. It's just like a clean constant look. You don't have the locking tab like that up there.
Okay.
Yeah, and that's super, super solid locking.
Awesome, Justin. Thank you so much. I appreciate your time, and have a great show.
Thank you.